Hello, my fellow viewers. I have received my Christmas presents today for this year's Christmas. And I got some interesting stuff here. I have new iPod charger, which I can use eventually. And then I also got some red Apple earbuds. And then also I got a new USB port, so a lot of techie stuff this year. And then I got from my Secret Santa at work, so you know, the Secret Santa thing, I got me a MLP drink cup set with the Rainbow Dash Pinkie Pie Twilight and a Flutter Pie there. Fluttershy Pinkie Pie. So hot and cold drink set. Never really used anything like this before. But pretty cool. Celebrate friendship and hello, friends. And then I also got, as far as the Secret Santa thing, I got this little Rainbow Dash thing. It's pretty cool. Let me show you what it does. Let me turn off the lights. And look at that. She lights up. It does that for 10 minutes and she turns off. And then I also got at work, each of us got, remember how I got those big reindeer on Thanksgiving Day? Let me show you, they're right there. See them? Well, I actually have a little one. I'm going to call this guy Little Comet. It's Team Santa. It's a exclusive employee only item right here. But it's pretty cool either way. Comet Jr. I also have me a new GoPro head strap because I messed up my other GoPro head strap last year and broke it because I got too reckless with it when I did all my pool fighting videos. That's why all my BronyCon footage was done with the chest strap instead of the head strap. But next year, I'm doing it with the head strap. I also have some Seas molasses chips, milk chocolate, and then I also got some new things for my drum kit. I got me a two cymbals here to replace my ones that are cracked. Let me show you. That's how bad it is. And that's how bad it is. A lot of rough play has gotten these things to look the way they are. But let's get back to the presents. I also have an external Blu-ray DVD player for my computer and also will work as a disk drive as well. So I can play Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 again, which will be great. And my Roller Coaster Tycoon 2 disc I got over the summer when I worked at that Arc retail store. I also have, remember at BronyCon how my tripod broke during the Buy Some Apples to Apples panel? Well, I got a new tripod and this one's a lot more robust. And extends up to 75 inches, has a carry handle, 3-section aluminum leg. A lot of good stuff here. Extends up to 75 inches in height, which would be great for filming panels. Next year at AMA Detour, MLPMSP, BronyCon, and whatever panel cons I plan on going to. Like, hopefully Ponyville Cyberfest and maybe BabsCon, but probably not since John Delancey's not going to be there. I also have me two t-shirts. I got a vinyl scratch t-shirt, which I'll be wearing at the next MLP related thing I go to, which might be either a post-New Year's party on January 2nd or the next one's for a meetup at the Mall of America, which I have been attending those since November, and they are pretty fun. I also have another Kiss shirt. Since, as you guys know, I saw Kiss twice this year in Bristol, Virginia, and here in Minneapolis. This is what they looked like back in 2010, like about 5 years ago. Hard to believe it's been that long. Feels like only yesterday I was still in high school, but I'm not. So I have some Lionel ornaments. I got me the Pennsylvania Torpedo locomotive and the tender to go with it, as well as the observation car, B-1 based off of a train set from the 1930s. Durable metal construction and exquisite building. The 1936 Lionel torpedo model train set is an enduring example of Lionel's innovation and craftsmanship. Even in the depths of the Great Depression, the set included the 238E Pennsylvania torpedo engine. This thing right here. The 265W whistling tender. This one, I think W stands for whistle. And the 601 passenger car, well, observation car, this guy. The streamlined 238E engine was modeled after Pennsylvania Railroad's torpedo K4 Pacific steamers, which debuted in 1936. The 238E brought the real thing down to size. A true-to-life detail boasted a working headlight that shone from its distinctive sun-nose boiler, along with eye-catching design touches like its decorative wing emblems and chrome handrails. I also have right here the Lionel North Pole Express little baby train. These things will be put on my tree here next year. We also have the gold variant of the torpedo locomotive. I also have my GoPro. I got a strap that my dogs can wear, and it says police on. I think it's supposed to be a little bit of a joke thing, but that is pretty nice anyway. So I got Madison and Ariel. This is coming your way. 2015. Let's see who else we have.
Hello. Hello, guys. It's me.
Creepy Twilight?
Yes. I am now here in Minnesota, apparently. I'll be visiting you time from time while also spending my time out with Bins Toybin and Creepy Teddy, Creepy Carl, and the occasional voice of her Creepy Grandma.
What happened to your voice?
I got a cold.
So in other words, Creepy Twilight's visiting us.
Yes. Now can you show me fully to the camera so you can show off my exquisite looks? Yes, it's me. I'm here, and I can see the ground. I'll wait over here.
Okay, looks like Creepy Twilight's now a Christmas present. So anyways, besides that, we got some more stuff here. And it's pretty much all Thomas stuff. We has Take and Play Timothy. And then the Trackmaster Scared James. We'll be fixing up his buffer soon, like I did to the other Trackmasters I have of the 2.0 series. The James in the One set, the Snow Colored Thomas, the Gator, and Timothy. And then I also have. What's next? I also got Diary of Wimpy Kid The Long Haul. Signed copy, just like my other Diary of Wimpy Kid books I got 2 years ago. I also have $125, so expect me to do a toy hunt soon, hopefully. Well, I'm gonna pick up some more toys at Toys R Us, Target, Walmart, wherever I decide to go. I also got me M&M's, which I've been dying for some candy anyway. And then I also have, what can I show next? A $105 gift certificate to Careful Canopy Trails, which is when you go up on the treetops and do zip lines and all that good stuff. Sounds like a lot of fun. I'll be doing some GoPro footage of that next year if I do that. With a free folder, which will be good for college since I'm starting college in like about 3 weeks. First time. But I'll still be doing videos as best as I can. I also have some next stuff to show. Oh, wait. This is one thing I need to show. This thing I wanted to get for a few years. And remember how last year I had all those used Thomas Friends trains that I got and I was just so glad to get those? Well, they strike again. We have a Wilbert. And where I saw this Wilbert came from Tennessee. And don't start in those bad 10IC jokes. Those jokes suck. He's a little bit of chips on him, but he otherwise looks really nice. after being discontinued since 2002. So you go be settled over. And now we also have this. It's the Sodor Railway Repair. This is the actual bag that came in. It came from Boca Raton, Florida, according to the packaging. And it even includes these little character cards, still decent condition. This guy's in decent condition, but I'm just glad to have him. See him up close. I know G. Olivier will get him this year from what I saw. And this thing is removable. Just slides into his little nub. Try to do this in one hand. Like, come on. This. Get it. There you are. Aw, really? Put all the effort in for nothing. Oh, that's how you slide it in. Once we got the little, get him out. These little things which sway from side to side. And they sway back. Get connected up. Connect to this little truck and he's ready to roll. With his little card in tow. Excuse me. That was not me. That was little Jack. Now we also have the Bachmann Iron Airy. Looking all smug. And Iron Burt, which makes me wonder, what is Bachmann going to do next year? I still hope they do Bachmann Rosie. I would really love it if they make Bachmann Rosie. I really want to get it. And speaking of Bachmann trains, the last item I have here is actually coming in later on. I do have a little image of it that I can show you. And for those of you who don't know this, I love Cactus 190706's Thomas series. And there's this one character in there that I think is really great, but he's also really insane. But I'll tell you after I show you my next item. And we have this big hunkin' heavy thing here. It's an amp. Remember how last year I got a guitar? Well, I have an amp for it now. Plus also a little cord to connect it up with. And this thing, I'm gonna play it around with one of these days. So I learned how to play guitar. It's a VIP. See what it says? It's a Viper VIP 3. I don't know how good this thing is and how it works, because I don't know anything about good amps and bad amps. But if anybody who knows out there in the music industry can tell me anything about it, please let me know in the comments below. But, what I was saying earlier, Cactus 190706 series. This item's going to be coming later on. It's an insane character. He's away the duck, and he ends up becoming, in the recent special, The Circle of Time, recent Halloween special, he becomes the most evil engine ever built. This is an image of him, and it's not the actual product. But anyways, his name is him. Steam Engine. I'm getting Steam Engine here. He's coming soon. Don't know when he's coming, but he's coming back. You may have thought that when we last saw him Kwan Ka, that he would be the end, but he's coming back. If anybody ever wants me to discuss my thoughts on that special, post a comment below and I'll make a little video on my thoughts of Steam Engine. I might mention them in my video. Well, yeah, probably not, because probably upload in one straight shot because of my whole YouTube shutdown. And the fact that it's Christmas and my videos are not fully uploaded, probably won't be any time. But until then, thanks for watching, and hopefully next year, 2015, my YouTube channel will be back to the way it used to be and even better. I hope that is the case. Until then, I will see you later. I, who used to be known as Thomas Lizzy Fan 1, but is now Thomas Lizzy Fan 2 and TFM 1, still like be called Thomas Lizzy Fan 1 or TFM 1. I'm signing off, people. I'll see you then. Remember how earlier I said in this video that I have an engine that looks like a character from Cactus 190706's Tom's Friends series coming here? Well, sure enough, this guy's arrived. He looks all cool and he's got the 5775 number. So we're gonna take this guy out of his packaging and I can show you what he looks like. I don't know why, but this part's floating around the packaging. But anyways, the model, pretty interesting way to open it, because I actually, when I first got this guy, didn't know how to open him. I mean, first you gotta slide this plastic, so I mean, this guy is really, and I mean, I'm serious, this guy really is well-protected model. There's actually a little trick with getting this guy out of the packaging. You actually gotta pull a little tab over here, and then that opens up, and voila, he's out of the packaging. So let's pull him out and get a look at him. So as you can see, he looks really fantastic. Let's turn around, do the full 360 shot like I did last year with the other models I had acquired. And that's what he looks like. Oh no, what's this? Oh no, it's Steam Engine! He's back. I thought he died and became Quan Ka. Rubbish. I am not Quan Ka. I am Steam Engine. I don't know who this Quan Ka is. Oh, excuse me. My voice is kind of a bit off today. Sodor is not gonna like this. Clearly is not. And here's Arian Bird out of the packaging. Side note, and they do look pretty nice, but I can't really tell them apart, honestly. I mean, I know the fandom does know a way to tell them apart. Well, the Thomas fandom, not the Pony fandom, but I honestly can't tell them apart. I can see that. I do know this is Bert, and this is Ari. So, let's turn them around and see what we have for Bert. And now Ari's turn. Looking really nice there. They are. So let's get these engines on the rails and see how they run. As well as Steam Engine. On second thought, even though the lighting is not the best, and I did put them back in the packaging just to carry them easily down to my layout, I did realize that Bert here actually has more fuzz on his his face. More beard fuzz, or peach fuzz, than Ari does. And now Steam Engine is on the rails, so let's give him a little run. And he runs really smoothly. He's gonna cause a lot of trouble. Let's get Duck on the rails and see if he can outrun Steam Engine. And this will be very interesting to see if Duck can outrun his evil brother. Oh, look at that. Duck can actually run Steam Engine. Oh, Let's see if Emily can outrun Steam Engine. And he caught up with her. Now it's time for Bert to run and make his first run ever. Let's roll, Bert. So let's see if Harry and Bert can catch Stepney, or will he outrun them and get to the Blue Whale Railway. Let's see, and roll. Oh, looks like they're gonna catch him. They're going to catch him. Stepney, come on, run away, come on. Run away from them, run away. And he did it! And we got Trackmaster Scared James down the track. Now let's take a look and see his scared face. But wait a minute. This needs to be addressed. I always have to with these new Trackmaster models. Trackmaster 2.0, as I like to call them. You always have to color in the buffers like this. Maybe I might as well just fast forward and actually just get to the part after I've colored the buffers and show you what I've done. There we are. Now he looks better and is ready to go. I also moved James from the Castle Quest set over to the Tale of the Brave set because this is kind of more fitting set for him because, well, this James is based off of the James from, well, Tale of the Brave. So, yes. Time to get him ready and rolling. Let's do this right now. I think probably he's scared because he saw Steam Engine. You know, it makes sense because Steam Engine was a big threat in Cactus 1907-06's Tower series. And I might continue to reference that because the series is just so awesome. Rise of Steam, Curse of Dutchman, Circle of Time, Dark World, great fan-made Thomas films that I think need a good look at. Along with Great Goodbye and all kinds of other things, and kind of are based off of real events with the fictionalized stuff in there as well, like fantasy and things like that. So I do recommend it, the series, good stuff, especially the movies. But this item, it's alright. And I derailed James, he didn't derail by himself. So anyways, I've heard, according to Trackmaster Wiki, that they were supposed to release a Marion instead of the Scared James. But that got cancelled for whatever reason, just like how Trackmaster Millie got cancelled, so probably won't ever see her. Unless they actually decide to make her in Trackmaster 2, which you gotta make Millie, because Millie's awesome. But for those of you who've seen channels on YouTube that have shown that Trackmaster set, you know the one where the trains can actually ride on one rail? Kind of bit like, let me demonstrate with Thomas, kind of like this. Which is really cool. Dangling on one rail like a balancing act. I kind of think this Scared James would be better off for that set. And then they should have released Marion if you ask me. But, well, costs and things like that, probably that all kicked in. But they could have made Marion look pretty cool and they actually could have had, if you wanted to, a movable steam shovel feature. But would that have affected her moving mechanism since she can move by herself? But you could have done the steam shovel thing where her arm and actually move, kind of like this, kind of like what Trackmaster did with Rocky, the original Trackmaster, and Tomy did about, well, about 2006-2007-ish, it's been that long. Kind of just something like that, that would have been pretty cool to see. But, oh well, let's hope for Tomy in 2015. But wait. That's it! We've gone through all the Christmas stuff. Christmas presents, everything. Toys, trains, everything. Anyways, that's it. Thanks for watching this quick video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Wait, this isn't a quick video. This has been pretty long. I'm sure it's been about 10 minutes. Anyways, thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Oh, wait. Probably been 20 minutes. And I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.